Hey guys, what's up? Roman here from Tech Guides, and in today's video I'm gonna show you guys how to set up a wildcard SSL certificate for your home server. Now in the last video I showed you guys how to set up Apache as a reverse proxy in order to connect different subdomains to different web apps running on your home server. Now if you haven't seen this video, then definitely check it out in the card right now. Now in today's video, I'm gonna expand upon this setup and show you guys how to set up a wildcard SSL certificate, which then allows you to access all of your different subdomains via secure connections. This is very important because if you do not encrypt your connections, then all of the traffic that is going from the user to your home server is unencrypted and prone to eavesdropping. But first, this video is once again sponsored by my friends over at Hostinger. I've been using Hostinger for pretty much half a year now. I'm using it for my blog and for all of my tutorials, and Hostinger has been absolutely fantastic. So if you're looking for a great deal on a domain name, for virtual private servers, or simply for web hosting, then definitely head over to the link in the description below, and don't forget to use code TechGuides upon checkout to get an additional discount on your order. But without any further ado, let's jump right into today's tutorial. First, let's start with a few prerequisites. You want to have Apache up and running on your home server, and you also want to have a few apps that you want to point your subdomains to. In my case, I have the blog subdomain pointing to a WordPress blog, whereas the cloud subdomain is pointing to my Nextcloud installation. Next, you want to have either a bought domain, for example from Hostinger or another domain hosting company, which points to your home server, or a free domain, for example from CloudDNS, which again points to the IP address of your home server. Next, you're gonna need CertBot in order to retrieve your own Let's Encrypt SSL certificates. To install CertBot, type in sudo apt-get update, followed by sudo apt-get install software-properties-common. Now add the universe repository by typing in sudo add-apt-repository universe, and finally the CertBot repository by typing in sudo add-apt-repository PPA colon certbot slash certbot. Now type sudo apt-get update again, followed by sudo apt-get install certbot python-certbot-apache. Note that for your convenience, all of these instructions are now also on my new blog, techguides.youtube, which is linked in the description below, where you can simply copy-paste all of the instructions one by one. Now in order to obtain a wildcard SSL certificate using CertBot, you have to type in sudo certbot cert only dash dash manual dash d star dot your domain, so in my case this is techguides.youtube dash d, then the regular domain without the wildcard, so techguides.youtube in my case, dash dash agree dash tos dash dash no dash bootstrap dash dash manual dash public dash ip dash logging dash ok dash dash preferred dash challenges dns dash 01 and finally dash dash server the let's encrypt url. Once you press enter, you will be presented with this long sequence of letters and numbers which you should copy and then paste under the txt dns entry of your domain registry. As host, you want to type in underscore acme dash challenge dot your domain. Press enter and repeat these steps for the second challenge. On CloudDNS, this looks almost exactly identical, so click on TXT DNS record. Under host, type in underscore ACME dash challenge, and under points to the long string given by CertBot. Now before you proceed, you have to make sure that the DNS changes have actually propagated over the internet. Now depending on the domain registry that you're working with, this might take from 1 minute up to 1 day. And in order to test if your DNS changes have actually registered with the DNS servers, you can go to dnslookup.online and enter the acme-challenge.yourdomain under the domain name field. Once your changes are recognized, go back to the shell and hit enter. And if everything went according to plan, you should have now obtained your wildcard SSL certificates. As you can see, the certificate is only valid for 3 months, so after these 3 months, you'll have to execute the steps shown up until this point once again. Now change directories to etc. apache2 sites-available and open the default SSL configuration file. In here, you should add a virtual host block pointing the port 443 to the regular server name, so your domain name, that you've registered either on Hostinger or Cloud DNS. Then you wanna enable the SSL engine and specify the certificate that you've just obtained under the SSL certificate file directive, as well as the private key under the SSL certificate key file directive. You can find the keys under etc. let's encrypt live / your domain. As you can see, in my case, this domain is now simply serving the var www/html directory on my home server. Press Ctrl X, Y, and Enter to save your changes. Next, we need to enable the SSL configuration file in Apache, so type in sudo a2nsite default-ssl.conf. Also, we need to enable the SSL module, so type in sudo a2nmod-ssl. Additionally, we're going to need the rewrite module in order to redirect unencrypted connections to port 443. Finally, type sudo service apache2 restart in order to restart the Apache service. Now, by adding the HTTPS prefix to your domain name, you should now be able to securely connect to your own server. Assuming that you also want to encrypt your connection to your next cloud, which is running under cloud.yourdomain.com, you also have to add another virtual host statement in the default SSL Apache configuration file. You can see the configuration on screen right now, but as I mentioned before, you can find all of these configurations on my new blog techguides.yt. Now, this only applies if you've installed Nextcloud the regular way, so it's running under the var www/html/nextcloud directory. On the other hand, if you're running Nextcloud as a snap instance, you want to change the default ports that the Nextcloud snap is using to ports that are not used by Apache. So for example, I'm using port 81 for unencrypted connections and port 444 for encrypted ones. Also, in order for the Nextcloud snap to be able to use our wildcard certificates, we need to copy them over to the Nextcloud snap directory. So type in sudo copy the cert, chain, and privkey file. Now make sure to actually rename the privkey to simply key.pem in order for this to actually work. Once the certificates are in the Nextcloud directory, type in sudo nextcloud.enable-https, then custom -s, cert.pem, key.pem, and followed by chain.pem. Et voilà, once you press enter, the Nextcloud snap should be running encrypted. Finally, you also need to add a virtual host entry in the default SSL Apache configuration, which now proxy passes all of the traffic coming from cloud.yourdomain.com to the snap server running on port 444 on the local host. Finally, you need to modify the config.php file of Nextcloud to accept proxied connections from your own server. So add trusted proxies, then an array, and then the local IP address. Also make sure that the override.cli.url is set to the subdomain that you've just set up. Now, in order to ensure that all of the traffic coming to our server is redirected to a secure port, we need to set a rewrite rule on port 80. So edit the 00-default.config file in the sites available directory, add the only virtual host entry under port 80, which specifies that the rewrite engine should be enabled. The rewrite condition is that HTTPS is off, which should be the case if a user is accessing your server under port 80. And finally, the rewrite rule ensures that all incoming connection, even on subdomains, is redirected to the secure connection. Finally, here's an example of a virtual host entry in order to encrypt connections going to my WordPress blog. And that about sums up today's video. It is actually that simple to set up a wildcard SSL certificate for your own home server. If you still have any questions, then don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section down below. And do make sure to check out my blog, where you can find additional information on this exact video. But that's it from my side for this video. Thank you so much for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.